Hi guys, today we are in the company of iPhone XS, just updated to iOS 18 developer beta. Surprisingly, even this year the iPhone XS remains one of the devices updatable to the latest version of iOS. And we will use it today to take a look at the main innovations of this new operating system. Obviously, keep in mind that being a beta, some changes, some new features may not have been definitively implemented yet. But I have to say that from an initial analysis, most of the announced new features are already present in the first beta, and I must say that they work quite well. So let's start immediately by seeing some information relating to the update, which, as we were saying, is iOS 18. This is the version number. It is obviously a beta version. In fact, in software update, we can see that the developer profile is activated. Okay, so let's immediately take a look at the settings that have been slightly revisited, both from a graphic point of view. In fact, we see that here. Some sections are presented with an icon and a brief description, but above all from the point of view of the order and therefore the arrangement of the items. For example, the battery option is present in this first menu. And we see some of the same information that was previously there, simply repositioned here at the top. Just as we then have a whole series of information very similar to that of before, but we will realize that the entire menu is shorter, since the applications part has a separate submenu. In fact, in apps we find the list of all applications and their respective submenus. Apart from this new feature, I would say that other features are a bit scattered among the various settings items, but these are the main new features. At this point, let's focus especially on the home screen, which has several new features. First of all, the first thing I noticed is that from an aesthetic point of view, the transparency and blur effect is no longer present, both under the app library and under the widgets panel. Then we have the background directly and above the layer with the widgets. One of the most important new features is the possibility of customizing the icons and colors of the home screen. How is this setting implemented? If you hold down Edit, this menu will appear. We will click on Customize, and here we can first modify the width of the icons. So it is possible to enlarge the icons and remove the label, therefore the writing, the name of the icons with this effect. It's actually quite cartoonish, very playful. But above all, it is possible to give a different theme to the icons, both with the dark and with a tint which allows you to color them differently. Not only the icons, but also all the widgets and elements on the home screen. I will show you the effect. All the icons are colored. And this change also applies to third-party applications, Facebook, Figma, Fiverr, Airbnb. Everything is colored based on the theme we have set. You can also use large icons with your custom theme. So as we can see, you can set the auto theme directly to the dark theme. Also change the background mode, choose the size of the icons, or set a particular color for the icons. The dark theme is currently applied only to system applications. In fact, we see that third-party applications remain with their original graphics. Let's now move on to another new feature, that of being able to choose the position of the icon. This was a function that had always been present on Android. It took almost 15 years to be able to select where to insert the icon without it being positioned at the top. The operation is very intuitive, very simple to use. I'll also show you some other news that hasn't been announced directly in the keynote, but you can see that if we go to modify a widget, for example, it will allow us to modify its size directly from the home screen. In edit mode, among other things, this handle will appear, which will allow us to do the same thing even faster. I will now show you another new feature of the update, namely the possibility of setting Face ID for opening a single application. But not only that, we can also hide that application from the home screen. And this application will then be present in, now it's asking me to hide Netflix. The application and name will be obscured. We will not receive notifications or calls. Let's go hide Netflix, and now I'll show you where to go to find the application. In the app library menu, at the bottom, there will be a hidden folder. By clicking and going to give the OK with the Face ID, here it will be presented to us. In this case, the Netflix application will check with the Face ID to unlock its content. So I have to say that it is still a convenient way to be able to find the hidden applications, but at the same time, it allows you to add an extra level of privacy. One last new feature is that you can make an icon. Directly a widget, just as you can make a widget directly an icon, that is, the icon associated with the application. This is about the new features of the home screen. Let's quickly focus on the lock screen, because here too there are some quite interesting new features. So, in addition to there being some new wallpapers, these are the official ones of iOS, which are also very nice because they introduce this transparency effect, which in my opinion is very successful. Let's see that it is finally possible to go and select the type of shortcut to use inside the lock screen below. In this case, we are going to change the flashlight and camera with calculator and energy saving. And here in this configuration, holding down on the calculator will obviously take us back to the dedicated app. An application that, among other things, has had a slight modification, allowing you to solve mathematical equations directly in a visual way. These are the main new features of the lock screen. I would say to go and check what are the new features of the control center. Here too, there has been a fairly important change in operation. Let's analyze the application in order. At the top right, you will notice that the button to turn off the device is immediately present. Here at the top, you can modify the control center list by adding controls. The list is quite rich. Obviously, this menu still lags a little, but in general, I realize that this is one of the least optimized parts of this beta one, also because very often in the reorganizing the elements, as you can see, they don't always respond quickly. The nice thing is that you can actually choose which elements to use, choose the position of the elements to use. But above all, you can also choose the size of these elements, so it is really possible to customize this screen as you want, which among other things is not limited to being a single screen, but you can add pages. These pages are always customizable, as you can see, and therefore we can choose to create our own control center based on our needs. Each widget is customizable. For example, I'll show you the music widget, which supports many layouts from 4x4 to 4x1. Up to the full screen version. So these are the main innovations of the control center. Let's now quickly focus on some applications that have been revised, redesigned, or redesigned. Let's start with the photos application that has been redesigned from top to bottom. And we will find this hybrid home screen. Among the list of photos, what we normally found therefore from the library with the possibility of choosing between years, months, and all photos. But scrolling up, we then find a whole list of other photos, also organized thanks to the use of artificial intelligence in the photos of the last few days, people and pets together with memories. Another interesting new feature is that it is possible to customize the order and type of sections present within the Photos application. And finally, I also wanted to show you the Fitness application, which has had a change, given that it is possible to modify the widgets, Therefore, the sections relating to our home screen, adding new ones. With this very rich and very customizable graphics. In fact, for example, we want to add this card. I think it's also possible, exactly, to position them correctly within the application. Guys, let's conclude this short tour with a very quick analysis of the performances, which I must say are also quite promising considering that we are talking about a 2018 phone. I haven't seen any glitches. Obviously, the battery tends to run down faster than normal, and let's conclude everything with a benchmark I carried out. I'll show you what this GPU benchmark looks like. The score obtained is 7,800 points, which is still a slightly lower score than the 8,600 points of iOS 17. The same thing also applies to the CPU benchmark, where if we look at the history, we notice that the scores are slightly lower than those of a stable version. But in any case, they are very respectable scores, and in general, as I was telling you, the impression is that of a system that is already quite clean and optimized considering that we are talking about the first beta for developers. So guys, that's all for this video. I thank you for watching and I recommend you subscribe to the channel because more videos will be coming soon on iOS 18. But above all, other comparisons with iOS 17 and the use of iOS 18 also on other devices. So thanks for watching and see you in the next video.